The provided block diagram shows the AXI DMA as the engine that transfers the data from the TAX buffer that we have here, from the address that we have in the DDR to the AXI stream master port, and it also transfers the data from the AXI stream slave port to the RX buffer that we have here, to the address of the RX buffer that we have here. Note that the AXI master, the AXI stream master, and the AXI stream slave, actually, they can be connected to the some peripherals that we have in the PO. For example, we can have some peripheral in the PO, and then that AXI stream master will transfer the data to that peripheral. Or we can have some peripheral that they are located in our PO site, and our target is to receive the data from that peripherals. But for this example, we are going to use a simple loopback mode. What does it mean? It means that whatever that we send to the PO site, whatever that we send to the AXI stream master, in the loopback mode, we will send them back to the AXI stream slave. So at the end of the test, we will expect that whatever that we had in the TX buffer after the one complete write and the read must be written into the RX buffer as well. So we say that the AXI DMA, the main job of the AXI DMA engine, is to offload the heavy duty of data transfer between the DDR memory and the PO site from the ARM core. For example, consider that we have 1 million of the data in the TX buffer. Does it make sense to transfer all of these data one by one with the ARM core? No. The DMA engine will do the job of the data movement, and our ARM core can do the much more important duties and the tasks like digital signal processing, data analysis, and etc. But still, the AXI DMA engine needs to be controlled and monitored. So we have a one AXI light that the ARM core is connected to that AXI DMA that give the access to the ARM core over that AXI light stream to the DMA engine. And the ARM core can configure the DMA for the correct data movement. For example, we need to set up the source address, we need to set up the destination address, and we also need to set up how many data we want to send to our DPO and then receive them back. So all of them at the before the transaction, before the data movement is done from the ARM core. ARM core can also read the status of the AXI DMA to detect that or AXI DMA is still busy with the data movement or is done with its job. And we can see that the AXI DMA has a five important ports. Memory map to a stream. The memory map stream read the data from the DDR and then write them to the AXI stream master. A stream to the memory map, receive the data from the AXI stream slave and write them to the DDR memory. Please note that the both MM2S and S2MM ports, both of these ports are master. So the DDR is the slave for the AXI DMA, and AXI DMA can easily read and write into the into our DDR memory. We have also two interrupts that they are related to these two ports. The first one is the memory map to a stream. When the memory map to a stream is done, when the memory map to a stream completely transfer the data from the DDR to the AXI stream master, this interrupt is asserted. Another interrupt is the stream to the memory map interrupt. When the AXI stream slave, when the amount of the data that we consider, for example, we consider 132 bits of the data to transfer from the AXI stream slave to that RX buffer. When this job is done, after that, the stream to memory map is asserted. We also have a streaming master and the slave ports. These two ports use for the highest speed data streaming between the DMA and the peripherals that they are located in the PL site. As I mentioned before, the AXI Lite interface also gives the complete access to the ARM cores, and by the help of that, let's say AXI Lite or the ARM core can control the AXI DMA and read its status. So for today's video, we are going to have two different scenarios and running the AXI DMA in the two different modes. The first mode is the pulling mode. So first of all, the ARM call will write some known data into our TX buffer. For example, it will write from the 1 to the 100 into the TX buffer. And then the ARM core will configure the DMA with the data movement parameters and then run it. To determine when the data movement is completed or not, the ARM core will continuously read and check the status register in the DMA engine. These status registers indicate whether the DMA is finished or is still busy. So that's why we call it pulling mode, because in a for loop manner, we need to check the DMA until it's done. In the second scenario, we are going to use these two interrupts that I mentioned them before. We use the two interrupts from the DMA to let the ARM core know when each transaction is completed. Interrupts allow the processor to perform other tasks while waiting for the event, and it will improve the efficiency of the ARM core a lot. So let's go and start our Vivado design. So I already created a project in Vivado for the ZCU104, and I already also created the block design. Let's open the block design and start to adding the IPs. So as usual, we start by adding the Zynq IP to this design. So I'm going to add the Zynq UltraScale IP block. And then we click on the Run Block Automation and we apply the board preset. All right, so we are going to add the DMA IP. So we select the AXI Direct Memory Access. Double click on the AXI DMA, AXI Direct Memory Access, and then deselect the Enable Scatter Gather because we are not going to work with the Scatter Gather engine. And for the width of the buffer, you can select the 23. It allows you to have a much longer data transfer. And you can leave the memory map data width and stream data width 32, 32, it's fine. And don't forget to check allow unaligned transfer as well. You can see our AXI DMA with the 5 mentioned ports. We are going to have a loopback for the AXI stream port. So you can see 2 AXI stream ports here with the tdata, tlast, tready, and tvalid, and easily connect these ports together by a loopback. So as you can see here, we have a 2 master port, memory map to a stream, and a stream to the memory map. But there is no slave port on the Zynq UltraScale IP. So double click on that and we are going to configure the available AXI ports in our Zynq IP. Then click on the PLPS configuration, PLPS interface, and in the slave interface, we are going to check the first AXI high performance port. So we are going to change a little bit in the master ports. As you can see, 2 ports are checked, but we only need 1 of them. So we are done. We have 1 AXI master port to connect it to our AXI Lite port, to connect it to the AXI Lite port of the DMA. And we have another, let's say, AXI slave port that the DMA, the 2 MM2S and S2MM ports of the DMA will be connected to that. So at this level, we can let the Vivado to automatically connect all the ports. So we can run again the connection automation. And we can see that the second slave port is added to the AXI Smart Connect. And then it's also connected to the AXI slave that we have here. For better understanding, I highlighted all the connected ports to the AXI DMA. You can see that the 2 master ports are, by the help of AXI Smart Connection, are connected to the AXI slave port of Zynq UltraScale IP, as we can see them here. And you can see that we have a loopback for the streaming ports, and you can see that the AXI light port of AXI DMA is connected to the AXI master port of the Zynq UltraScale IP. It allows the ARM cores to configure and monitor our AXI DMA. We need to validate the design. Please note that when we validate the design, it will assign automatically all the addresses that the ARM core or AXI DMA need for the communication to the DDR, or the ARM cores they need for the communication to the AXI DMA. So don't forget to validate the design. Otherwise, some addresses is possible that are not assigned. So it's successfully validated. Let's have a look also at the address editor. You can see that the AXI DMA has a two master ports, MM2S and S2MM. And both of those ports, they have 2 gigabytes of the range into our DDR memory. You can also see that the ARM core as the master has access to the AXI light port of the DMA. So after you validate, you should also double check that all the ports that you have are assigned correctly. Now we need to connect the interrupt pins from the DMA to the PLPS IRQ. So we need to add a concat block. Okay, and then we concat the both MM2S interrupt and S2MM interrupt, and then we connect them to the PLPS IRQ. Again, if you validate it here, we can see that the bit widths of the PLPS IRQ is increased to the 2 bits. In this case, when the AXI DMA assert one of these interrupts, the events will be sent to our ARM cores. So to debug the AXI stream ports and or AXI master ports, I'm going to add the ILA. Then I right click on each port and I select debug. So I need to repeat the job for all the ports that I want to debug them. I also want to debug the 2 interrupt lines that I have. So we can let the Vivado to add automatically an ILA for us. All right. I don't want to have 2 ILAs and I want to have only 1 ILA. So I'm going to delete the 2 extra ILA that I have. And I want to add 2 extra probes to the first ILA. So I change the type of the ILA to the mix. And I'm going to increase the number of the probes to the 2. If you want to have more samples in your debugging window, you can easily choose the 4096. In this case, if you want to send and receive a larger pack of the data with your DMA, and you want to debug completely all the events, if you want to debug whatever happened in your AXI stream port and in your AXI master port, you will be able to correctly observe them. So 2 probes and 4096, it will work fine for us. All right. So as you can see, I have 2 extra probes here. And I'm going to connect them to the interrupt pins of AXI DMA. Let's validate the design again. Okay, very good. We are almost done and we need to add a top wrapper to our design. We click on the create HDL wrapper and we let the Vivado to manage and auto update it. All right, very good. And now we can generate the bitstream. Our bitstream is successfully generated. All right. The last step that we need to do in the Vivado is to export the hardware. We go to the file, export hardware, then press next, and don't forget to include the bitstream.